There are plenty of fun hobbies, but very few that can actually make you rich. But Sid Witherington has a hobby that could do just that. Sid is a local history teacher who just happens to be one of the nation's top experts in metal detecting. He took me along with him on a hunt to some of the Mid-South's many Civil War sites. Just imagine, there could be buried treasure right in your own backyard.
There's a nice, clear creek that runs through the middle of this little valley back in here and in here. And it also made it a good place to camp in the Civil War.
Sid Witherington is a walking history lesson. When it comes to the Civil War, there isn't much about the Mid-South that he doesn't know.
And every town along the Memphis-Charleston Railroad, there were camps, mainly Union troops, but there were some Confederate soldiers there too, and also in North Mississippi, there were Confederate soldiers. And just in Germantown area, when I started really looking about 89, I just started asking on some property, and the first place I went was Morgan Woods, where they had a Germantown Festival. And I started finding bullets and buttons everywhere, and I just expanded my searching to adjacent areas. And I hit about 6 Civil War camps in Germantown that had never been hit before, and I was digging all kind of artifacts. And then I moved to Kourvelas, and then I moved to further down the road to LaGrange and Grand Junction, and everywhere I went I was finding stuff. Germantown's a rendezvous site in 1861 for the 4th Tennessee. And then in June 6, 1862, Memphis fell in the biggest naval battle of the Civil War. And then after that, West Tennessee and North Mississippi was kind of in Union hands the whole war.
In fact, the Battle of Collierville took place in 1863 near the railroad here. Some 200 soldiers died, and the Union General William Tecumseh Sherman was almost captured. All these Civil War era soldiers that have been here have left quite a few items behind them. And for 20 years, Sid has been finding, cataloging, and preserving those items.
I got 7,000 bullets and almost 1,000 buttons and 104 belt buckles from the Civil War. I found the rarest northern buckle there is this Ohio State breastplate I found off Germantown Road, not more than a quarter mile from the high school. And it's extremely rare. It's on a 10 scale, it's a 9. I found one of the rarest Confederate buttons and the rarest Confederate spur.
Actually, there's things more valuable. This is one of the neatest things. Is that bugle mouthpiece. Found that one at where the old Baptist church was in Germantown.
And that, you mean in the heart of old Germantown?
Oh, right in the middle of Germantown. And it was, you know, it probably blew the charge of shallow or something.
I have a big silver star that I found that's about that big around that I found in Kyle in a fire pit. And I'm sure they probably bend their hat over and stuck that silver star on their hat. And it was cut out of a big, kind of like a silver sheet, and then in the form of a star and then decorated. And, you know, I wonder about that. And I wonder who wore that, because whoever wore that was a pretty flamboyant person, I would imagine. And I'm sure it was a cavalry officer of some sort that wore that, and I thought it was really neat. And, you know, find artifacts like that. I have a silver spoon I found in Morgan Woods that's really big, coin silver, and it has WT initials on it, but on back it has scratched Hoffman. And it was right by a campfire that the 2nd Iowa soldiers that were camped out in Morgan Woods, right by the campfire, and I'm sure that it was some of Sherman's troops. They stole it from some southern household. And then he was eating and scratched his name on back so he wouldn't lose, and then lost it there.
Sid's fascination with the Civil War is in his blood. 10 of his relatives fought for the South, and he has 8 letters written home from the battlefields. His full name is Albert Sidney Witherington III. He was named for the highest-ranking Confederate officer killed in the war. When he's relic hunting, he knows what to look for.
You can actually see some of the Civil War debris over on that washed out area, some of the pottery and stuff from the camp over there.
You can actually see it above the ground?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I can walk out in the field and tell you if it's a Civil War camp before you even dig it because of the debris. Now, see, that's what you want to dig, something that sounds like that. And you can go slow, but you have to keep it moving. Yeah.
Next month, I'll show you what I found, and Sid will give you the rules of good metal detecting.
They used to dump stuff back here.
So there's a code, you know, of metal detecting. You're supposed to leave it better than you found it, right?
When you're digging in people's yards in Germantown, you need to... I've dug up some of the richest people in Germantown. You have to kind of make sure you don't mess up their yards.